Active Directory Certificate Services, ADCS, is a key Windows Server role that is indispensable in a modern Active Directory and Entra ID hybrid environment. This video continues a Windows Active Directory series focusing on key server roles and features. Here, we will install and configure a single Enterprise Certificate Authority, CA, using Active Directory Certificate Services on Windows Server 2025, which will handle the issuing and enrollment of user and computer certificates. The steps and procedures here also apply to Windows Server 2022 and earlier. An Enterprise CA must be a member server in an operational Active Directory domain. The computer name of the CA server cannot be changed after the Active Directory Certificate Services is installed and configured. Plan the hostname carefully before setup. The Certificate Services server should use a static IP address to ensure consistent DNS resolution and service availability. While an Enterprise CA integrates closely with Active Directory in production environments, it's recommended not to install the Certificate Services role on the domain controller. The CA name, which includes the CA server computer name by default, is permanent and immutable after configuration since it appears in issued certificates. The user performing the configuration must be an enterprise administrator. In Server Manager, Dashboard, click Add Roles and Features. At the Server Selection section, select the correct server when installing a role from a privileged administrative workstation. At the Server Roles section, select Active Directory Certificate Services and click the Add Features button. At the ADCS section, read the Things to Note and click Next. For role services, check the Certificate Authority checkbox. We'll cover the other role services in a later video. Click Next, followed by Install. When using Windows Server Core as server configuration, sconfig, select 15 to exit the PowerShell. Use the add-windows feature commandlet to install. Pass the -computer name argument to install remotely from an administrative workstation. Following the installation of the role and role service, there will be a yellow caution icon next to the status flag. Click Configure Active Directory Certificate Services on this computer. At Role Services, select Certification Authority. At Setup Type, leave the Enterprise CA Radio button selected, and at the CA type, leave the Root CA selected. Create a new private key. However, you can reuse an existing one if necessary. For private key cryptography, leave the default. However, I'm going to select 4096 for my key length. For the private key, CA name, and the validity period, leave the defaults. For the certificate database, leave the defaults or place it in another location, preferably on a different drive. In this example, I'm going to relocate the database and logs to C:\ENTCA. The CA database and logs can be relocated later after installation. Confirm the settings and click Configure. For Windows Server Core, use the install-ADCS Certification Authority commandlet with passed parameters to install. Hit Y to confirm. If configuring via PowerShell from an administrative workstation, do so via a remote PSS session. To verify the configuration, in Server Manager, Tools, Certification Authority, there should be a green check mark next to the server. Right-click the server and select Properties. Click View Certificate and select the Details tab to verify the settings. If you've selected a custom location, click the Storage tab to verify. Close the Property windows and the Certificate Authority MMC. Open an administrative terminal. Enter a remote PS session into each of your domain controllers. On all domain controllers, invoke a gpupdate/force. Open the Microsoft Management Console. File, add remove snap-in. Select certificates, computer account, local computer. Select certificates, computer account, another computer. Click the browse button. Enter your domain controller name and click check names. Select your domain controller, click OK, followed by finish. Select certificates again and do the same for your other domain controllers. Click OK when complete. Expand the certificates for the local computer and expand the personal certificates folder. You should see the certificate for your CA server. Expand the certificates for each of the domain controllers and expand the personal certificates folder. Notice the certificate issued to the domain controller from the CA with a default validity period of 1 year. Open the domain controller certificate and select the Details tab. Notice the public key length is 2048, even though our CA certificate is 4096. This is because the key length is derived from the domain controller certificate template. Our CA is in good working order. In the next video in this Active Directory Certificate Services series, we'll cover certificate templates, automatic enrollment, and group policy object, GPO, settings. I hope you enjoyed this video, learned something new, and found it useful. If you have any feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please let me know in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and pass it on to others. And I thank you for watching.